Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hens All Access's coverage of University of Delaware men's soccer. We are here at Delaware Mini Stadium for this NCAA first round matchup between the Red Storm of St. John's out of the Big East and your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. Thanks for joining us here on Hens All Access. I'm Kyle Coulter. Alongside me is women's assistant coach Neeton Soni. Neeton, how are we doing today?
We're doing well. We're placed perfectly between half of the Blue Hens, so this is going to be an exciting for us just as much as it is for the players on the field.
Should be a very exciting match. And for a quick insight pregame, we go down to the field where sideline reporter Jen DeLuca had a chance to catch up with head coach Ian Hennessy before the game. Jen?
Key to tonight's game is the energy from the crowd. Stands are filling up and it looks like it's going to be a pretty packed house. So a big play or maybe even an early energetic goal with the fans behind the Blue Hens will give them the advantage they need early on. So it's going to come down to the energy tonight, or as Coach Hennessy would say, the Henergy. Back to you, Kyle.
Thank you, Jen. We are back up here and should be a good one tonight. The Red Storm of St. John's coming in with a record of 10-6-2, and the Blue Hens coming with a record of 14-4-1. They lost a heartbreaker in penalty kicks, 7-6 the penalty kicks, to Drexel in the CAA semifinals. But they're looking to bounce back here. They still have one of the most high-powered offenses in the nation, tied for first in goals and second in goals per game. And they're going up against one of the statistically best defenses in the country. Neeton, what are you looking for from this game?
Yeah, you know, I had the advantage of actually being able to coach against St. John's back when I first started coaching. I was the assistant at Rutgers, and so they were our Big East foes, and so we know them pretty well. The team's very much built around the quality level of fitness, good defensive structure, and then they're very aggressive on the attack. So I expect to see a very, very exciting game between both of these teams today. You've got Delaware coming off the high of a great season, and then obviously, you know, an established St. John's team that's, this is not their first rodeo. I mean, they're veterans at making the tournament, so for them and for Delaware, it should be a very, very good test moving forward into the NCAA tournament.
You mentioned St. John's does have some experience there. This is their 20th time overall getting into the NCAA tournament. They won the whole thing back in 1996. Soccer is a big, big sport up there for the Red Storm. And the Blue Hens only making their fourth overall appearance. They did make it a couple years ago, so two of the last 3 years. This season they had their biggest bounce back year ever. They went 4-10-4 last year. They came back, added some freshman talent, including Guillermo Delgado, Jaime Martinez, and now they had their best record in program history, hosting their first NCAA tournament game since 1970, I believe. Yeah, 1970. Wow, that's a
It's been over 40 years since we've actually hosted an NCAA first round. I got a chance to catch up with the coaching staff for the men's team at Delaware here the past couple of days. There's a great feeling about this game, you know, regardless of what their opponent is. Then this team is ready and fired up. I think this has been a team that has really been able to prove people wrong time and time again this season. You know, people have St. John's pegged as the favorites, but on any given day against this Delaware team, I think you're going to have a challenge on your hands.
And we will take a break real quick as we honor America here with the playing of our national anthem. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back here on Hens All Access. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. And we were just going to give you the starting lineups here real quick. For the St. John's Red Storm, in goal, Rafael Diaz. And then on defense, Gene LeVay. Midfielder, Brandon Savino. Also on defense, Gabriel Kamara. At midfield, Cody Albrecht. At midfield, Jimmy Mulligan. At midfield, Danny Bedoya. On defense, Marco Borden. At midfield, Jamie Thomas. On defense, Tim Parker. And also at forward, Sean Seppi. And for your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens, in the cage, junior goalie, Borja Barbero. On defense, Tobias Mueller, Ignacio Martin, and Ben Sampson. We also have Guillermo Delgado, Roberto Jimenez, Jaime Martinez, Kyle Newell, Mark Garrity, Vincent Mediate, and Nicholas DiRienzo. So there you have it, folks. Both teams are ready. They are on the field, ready to kick off this NCAA tournament, and the crowd is excited as well.
Yeah, I mean, you can definitely feel like this is a playoff game. This is what it's all about. I mean, we talk about seasons. We talk about a preseason. We play about your regular season. You talk about your conference season, and then this is it. This is the payoff. And so there's definitely a feeling of a playoff game tonight. There's a huge crowd out here tonight. There's standing room only. And actually, frankly, if I wasn't here commentating with you, I probably wouldn't be able to get a seat.
It kind of looks like a Chelsea Man U game with the red and the blue going at each other.
Sure.
We got blue on our right, all the Blue Hens fans, and then the Red Storm traveled well. And we are underway here. Kyle Newell, pass it back to Ben Sampson. Both teams had players selected to their all-conference teams. Of course, the St. John's with 4 coming out of the Big East, and the Blue Hens with 8 coming out of the CAA. So a lot of talent here, a lot of young talent. And for the Red Storm, they are a young team. They only have 5 seniors on the squad as opposed to 10 for the Blue Hens. So I think it might come down to the goalie play tonight. Rafael Diaz of the Red Storm has had one of his best seasons in his college career. He's had 9 shutouts as the Red Storm attacked there. Career-high 9 shutouts. He's also second among all active goalkeepers with 32 career shutouts. And then, of course, Borja Barbero in goal for the Blue Hens has had a stellar season. So I think it might be able to who handles the pressure well enough tonight. The Red Storm attacking early.
Yeah, I it could be a game for goalkeepers, but, you know, it's going to be interesting to see how this plays out. We've got, you know, a good attacking team going against a good defensive team, but, you know, a goal here or there might change the way that the rhythm of this game goes. An early goal from either team as we kind of watch this play out here in the Delaware box. Yeah, you know, an early goal could really change the rhythm of the game and what we can come to expect, but otherwise I expect it to be tight. I expect it to be a cagey affair to begin with and then see what opens up.
These two teams did face each other way back in the preseason, but that was just only returning players. No freshmen were played in that game, and they tied in that one, so that wasn't really not a really good indicator.
Yeah, spring games are kind of tough, you know, to really gauge, you know, what, you know, at least you get a look at your, you know, the players that are actually going to be returning that year. But I'm sure Delaware would have really been paying attention to the games that, you know, St. John's have played up until now in the current season and really being able to pick apart, you know, where they feel like their weaknesses are and trying to exploit those in tonight's game.
And the two teams do have one common opponent. That's Seton Hall. St. John's just beat Seton Hall in their last match back on November 8th. 5-0. The Blue Hens actually lost to Seton Hall in double overtime, 5-4 earlier in the season. So, once again, that was very different times during the season. But hopefully that's not an indicator of how this game will play out tonight. But as we mentioned, the Red Storm with a very stellar defense and the Blue Hens with one of the best offenses in the nation behind freshman Guillermo Delgado and junior Roberto Jimenez and the other freshman, Jaime Martinez, all putting up huge numbers, pretty much dominating the CAA in their scoring categories.
Yeah. You know, when you've got a strike partnership that's working very well, it's very difficult to write off any team that you're playing up against. And they've already shown this year that they're communicating very well. They're working off each other very, very well. There's definite understanding that's been built between the two of them at this part of the season. So I don't expect any of that to change. It's just really about somebody settling down, the team settling down and finding momentum that's really going to help them to really find a footing in the game.
And the Red Storm are pushing hard early here. The Blue Hens defense kind of bending, not breaking here early so far. Kyle Newell able to clear that one away.
Yeah, this is very typical from from a St. John's team. Again, knowing both coaches and having worked alongside them or having coached against them, I expect both teams to really be aggressive, especially in the attacking third. This is definitely something that St. John's have done, typically over the last 4, 5, 6 years.
And you see the field here at Delaware Mini Stadium, kind of getting weathered here as the season goes on. It's very dry, and the ball's running a little bit quicker than it normally is, so pass is going to have to be on point tonight, as we saw just earlier there, that ball from Delgado, a little far for Jimenez. They've been working well together so far this season. Barbero comes out and handles that one. Quickly out to Garrity, the captain. Garrity taking his space up the left side. Brandon Savino on defense, looking for Jimenez. He's got Mediate. Good look up there to Jimenez.
That's
flag
a great
is
ball.
Not up. Jimenez with a shot and deflected away. Jimenez had a good opportunity there. I couldn't tell if that hit off. Couldn't tell if that hit off Jamie Thomas.
Yeah, I think it hit a defender on the way in on the side of goal. So, good resilient defense there from St. John's right off the bat.
And it seems like Roberto could have pulled the trigger there on the left foot, but he decided to switch it back over, and that extra second allowed the defenseman to recover. Kyle Newell cuts that one out nicely. Back to Sampson. Sampson plays it over to Martin, and we see Tobias Mueller back in the starting lineup tonight. It's been a while since we've seen him out there. He suffered an injury early in the season, but it's good to see him back out there in a game that really matters for the senior.
Yeah, again, I got a chance to chat with the coaching staff of Delaware about his return, and they feel supremely confident about him coming back into the starting lineup even after such an extensive period away from the game. There's obviously a lot of trust in him and what he can provide to the Delaware defense.
As Newell passed it back to Sampson. Sampson named to the all CAA rookie team. So congratulations to him. Him along with Mueller and Martin have played a really stellar back line this year. Given up, along with Barbero, given up just over a goal a game. Played very well. Kept their team in it a lot of. Kept the Blue Hens in it a lot of the times. And we'll look to see that from them tonight. Even though the Red Storm doesn't have a very powerful offense, the Blue Hens pretty much doubled this Red Storm stats in all offensive categories: shots, goals, and assists. But still, they, as we've seen early now, they are pressing hard and almost got a few shot attempts early. Takes in the middle. That's Rafael Diaz. Delgado looking forward. A beautiful ball to Jimenez. Up the left side. Back to his left. Good defense there from the Storm. Back to Garrity. Looking up for Di Rienzo. Was cut out there by Diaz. So a beautiful ball from Delgado. I wouldn't say wasted, but maybe not handled. But good defense there from the Storm.
Yeah, it's the initial attack looked like it had a lot of promise. And then when the Red Storm were able to get back behind the ball, kind of slowed down the play a little bit, and it meant that Delaware had to kind of keep the ball and be a little bit patient, which unfortunately in that particular attack they weren't. So let's hopefully they'll learn from that and they'll be able to change the tactic a little bit.
That errant ball off the foot of Mediate, played long, looking for Marco Borden. Sampson plays it back to Barbero, dangerous ball. Barbero has to kick it out to Newell. And it seems like the Red Storm are just flying all over the place tonight. They're coming out with a lot of speed and getting to those free balls. Throwing now to Jimenez.
Again, very typical of the Red Storm and the way that they're coached. Coach Mazur's definitely somebody that plays with a lot, played and coaches with a lot of intensity, and I fully expect his team to perform in that same manner.
Ball back to Sampson. Newell with it now. The one's trying to set up an attack here, changing fields. Mueller, another captain on this team. Trying to force one in there, finds Garrity. Blue Hens just can't seem to get it over the midline right now. Ball being fought for in the middle there. Blue Hens just trying to clear it, Mediate with it now. Looking long for Jimenez. Jimenez takes it in the middle. He's got Garrity on his left, looked for him. Back to Jimenez now. And that ball is cut out there by Thomas. Sampson. Jimenez. And from Martinez. Back to Jimenez. That ball a little far. Good idea there from the freshman.
Trying to Delaware, get Delaware going to have to show some patience here in the back. You know, obviously the St. John's team are being able to defend the ball with 11 people behind it. So it's going to be hard to kind of find those passing lanes and find those opportunities to get forward unless they create some space. And they're going to have to be careful about how they do that. But if they do, they'll find those pockets that the onlooking midfielders and forwards can check back into and provide some offensive chances for them.
Newell gets in there for that one. That one goes off the head of Mulligan. Martinez, ball goes a little far. Cut out there by Albrecht. Sean Seppi has it now. Seppi, the team leader in points and goals, has 6 goals on the season.
Delaware definitely looking to press high today, a little bit more high than I've seen them. I mean, they're squeezing their backs, they're squeezing their goalkeepers, and really trying to win that ball and keep it in the St. John's half. They probably know that any time that they have it in the defensive third, it's going to be really hard to break them down, so you might as well try to win it from them in their defensive third, and then really go on a quick attack to goal.
I'm sure Coach Ian Hennessy has been game planning nonstop for a while now, ever since they learned who they were going to be playing a few days ago. And I'm sure head coach Dave Mazur has done the same for the Red Storm. So two seasoned coaches and two gritty teams. Well, the Red Storm, they haven't really played in 2 weeks. They didn't make the Big East tournament. They did get an at-large bid. So they haven't really tested game speed in a while. The Blue Hens, as we mentioned, coming off that heartbreaking loss to Drexel just a few days ago. So they're still fresh, so to say. But I guess on the other end of that, you could say the Storm have very fresh legs. And you can see that earlier in this game. They're coming out with a lot of fire, coming out with a lot of speed. And that ball goes back to Diaz. The winner of this game will take on the University of Virginia on November 24th down in Charlottesville. Both teams have some history against Virginia. The Red Storm lost to UVA earlier this season, and the Blue Hens, in their last trip to the NCAA tournament 2 years ago, actually beat Virginia in the first round, which is an upset win. So there's some history between both those teams. We still have a lot of game to play there before we think about that. Up the right side is Seppi. Cutting back in the middle. Still with it now on his feet. Good defense there from Nolan Sampson, kind of converging on him. Mediate. Slides down, still fighting for it. Play from behind by Albrecht. In the middle, there's a shot. Cleared away by Martin. Martinez up the right side with Savino on defense. And that ball a little bit behind Guillermo Delgado. Good defense there from Martin. They wanted the call, not going to get it. Ball goes back to the Storm. Ball played out there. Storm with it now still. Albrecht for Zavino. Out wide for Thomas. Albrecht is looking for Mulligan. Cut out there by Mediate, but the ball goes back to the Storm.
Delaware doing a really good job there, really limiting the options to long balls, and then obviously when they're winning that ball back, looking for that quick release ball out to Jimenez and get him going, on the attack.
There's Thomas looking for Seppi, but good job using his body there. It was Mueller. Albrecht with it now. Out wide to Mulligan, to Thomas. With DiRienzo on defense, Newell now. Newell going against Borden. Albrecht. New and Borden still fighting for it. Ball goes out of play for Red Storm throwing.
Good period of group pressure there from Delaware. Really hunting down the ball in twos and threes and really trying to force an error from Red Storm, trying to find an opportunity to win the ball and then keep possession of it.
Sampson using his big frame there to get win back possession. Newell with it now. And you mentioned the Hens really pressing forward a lot and pressing when the Storm are trying to clear. Storm are doing the same thing on the opposite end. It seems like both teams are having trouble clearing out of their own defensive zone tonight.
Yeah, it's going to be tricky. I mean, you can see that the game's really being only really being played in about 70 yards of space between the Delaware back line and the Red Storm back line. So it's very tight in the middle. The spaces are really behind those back lines, but there's not enough of it to really to cause a problem. So it's really going to be about how patient you are with the ball when you get it and using those opportunities when you do have time and space wisely.
And you mentioned it is standing room only here. They have set up a fence behind the Delaware goal, and you can see it's completely lined with fans looking for Seppi up the right side. He's got him. Sampson on defense. Sampson and Newell cut back into the middle. No one's there, so good defense, as you mentioned, coming over in twos and threes to really force an error, and they did right there. Garrity coming back in the middle. Albrecht on defense. Out wide to Martinez. There's LeVay on defense. Martinez looking for Delgado. Good defense there from Tim Parker. Be a lot of fellow UD athletes coming here to see. I see it. Saw a bunch of members of the football team, and the baseball team is lining the fence. So some, and I saw your women's soccer team here,
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, they're out here in force. I see a few other teams lined up here up against the fence. They got here a little bit too late and couldn't find a spot on the bleachers.
Everyone's hearing about Delaware soccer. Hopefully they continue their play. You know, the last game we did here on Hens All Access together was a 0-0 draw against Northeastern, and then Roberto Jimenez won it in double overtime on a penalty kick. So maybe you're good luck. Maybe we'll – it's a good thing you're back. Martinez for Delgado.
Anything to help us win a game.
Delgado taking up the right side, looking to cross it in. Wins Delaware a corner kick. They broke their single-season record for corners this season. This would be their 141st corner of the season.
Yeah, this is an area I think that we probably could do a better job of capitalizing on, having so many corners and having scored relatively few goals from set pieces, or certainly corner plays. This is an area that I would definitely want to be focused on in terms of getting a goal, especially in tight games like this. You don't expect this to be a very open game where there's four or five goals going in from each team. So set pieces become very, very important in establishing some sort of attack.
And a interesting play there. Played it instead of going into the box, played it back to Newell, who took a one-time shot. Couldn't quite get enough on it to test Diaz there, but a good attempt there from the Blue Hens on their first corner of the night. Thomas now. Looking up for Borden. Borden and Sampson. Borden's got a step up the right side. Sampson on defense. Borden separating himself. And Mueller has to just clear it away. Seppi was right behind him. It will be a Red Storm corner. As it looks like we have Joe Dupree warming up there on the sidelines for the Blue Hens. Looks like it'll be either Thomas or Mulligan over to take it. Looks like it'll be Bedoya. Bedoya crosses it in. There's a shot! And a goal there from the Red Storm.
Yeah, it's a tricky corner to defend, that one, when they had so many people around the corner box, and then they kind of from the corner kick, and then they kind of spread out, causing a little bit of confusion there from Delaware, and then a lucky bounce from the Red Storm, and they were able to capitalize. That's unfortunate from Delaware.
Some terrific pace on that shot. Barbero got both hands on it, but couldn't quite keep it out of the goal. That goal coming from Gabriel Camara. That is Camara's first goal of the season. And St. John's, 18 minutes into this game, goes up 1-0. And that is the best news for the Red Storm, because there is a staggering statistic. Since 2010, the Storm is 41-1 when scoring first. This season, they are 9-0-1 when scoring first. So once they get a lead, they tend to keep it. And the Blue Hens are going to have to break that trend right now as they're attacking here. Looking up for Jimenez. Jimenez has got it. And pushed out there by Camaro. DiRienzo now on it. So the Blue Hens looking to get one right back there, trying to catch the Storm napping. But the Blue Hens in their last game against Drexel were down 2-0 at halftime, ended up coming back and tying it late. So they're no stranger to gritty games.
Yeah, I mean, you know, statistics, as good as they are in terms of establishing a tone and an anticipation for the game, you know, when you get to that 90 minutes, you're up against anything crazy can happen. So knowing Delaware and knowing that they've come back from games where they've been, you know, two goals down and coming back and tying it or finding a way to win a game when it's been tight, I wouldn't put it past them. This is definitely a team that could change that statistic in a heartbeat.
You're right. If there's team with any offense that could do it, it's the Blue Hens.
Absolutely.
As the Red Storm gets a free kick. Call on Kyle Newell. So it'll be either Bedoya or Mulligan to take it. So another set piece here quickly after their goal. Bedoya puts it into the middle. And that ball goes out of play. We'll see what the call is. Looks like they're giving the goal kick to the Blue Hens. So the Hens able to defend that one nicely. Put two bodies on the Red Storm attacker. Remember, fans, you can follow the Hens on Twitter at twitter.com/UDBlueHens and get live updates, as well as stats and post-game recaps, as well as pictures. Also become a fan on Facebook at facebook.com/BlueHens. Post-game videos, highlights, pictures, recaps, and much more. That's at facebook.com/BlueHens. There's LeVay with Martinez on defense. The Storm looking to clear it. He's got Borden up. Sampson on Borden. Cuts it back into the middle. Martin now coming back to help out. And we're going to get a call there against the Blue Hens once again. So another free kick here for the Storm. About 10 yards or so outside the 18. I would imagine Bedoya would take this one as well. 24 minutes and 30 seconds left to go here in the first half. Once again, thank you for joining us here on Hens All Access. Alongside Neaton Sony, I'm Kyle Coulter. And here's the kick. Ball into the middle. And that ball goes just wide.
Yeah, I think the goalkeeper had that, you know, covered all the way out to the post. Looked probably a lot dangerous than it actually was.
They were looking for the goal scorer, Gabriel Camara, to put a head on it. Couldn't quite get there, and the ball goes out of play. It will be a Blue Hens goal kick.
Go, Johnny! Keep it up! Go, Johnny!
Yeah, Delaware really need to find a rhythm in the game, really find some success in their offensive attacks. You know, it really only takes one strike or one really good opportunity to really build some confidence and then go on, like, you know, a good successive run of offensive form. So if they can find that one break, I would imagine that we would have a really good game on our hands.
And we had a collision here just over midfield. And as we wait to resume play, remember, fans, you can also check out Hens All Access for our weekly web chat social media chat show. Called Blue Hens Lunch Break. Check out the most recent one with head women's basketball coach Tina Martin, as well as two UD players. That one's on our archive. That's every other Thursday at 1 o'clock. Also, you can check out Blue Hens Beat, our biweekly web show, dedicated to everything Delaware athletics. Gives you the behind-the-scenes look you need. We just had a new one posted up on Monday, so you can check that one out on Hens All Access. That's Blue Hens Beat. Both teams rally around number 17, Jamie Thomas, who went up with Roberto Jimenez and must have caught either an elbow to the face, but he's down right now as both teams huddle up looking to regroup. So we're about halfway through this first half. What are your impressions so far?
I think Delaware really need to kind of find a little bit of confidence in the game, and that can really come from, you know, really good opportunity in the game, or really a good opportunity on goal, or a successive run of two or three, you know, waves at the St. John's goal to really establish an attacking rhythm. I think that's what's been really lacking in Delaware tonight, is really establishing themselves in the way that they want to play and enforcing that on St. John's. To some degree, it's been the other way around, where St. John's have really been able to dictate what's going to happen in the game. And that needs to change slightly in order for Delaware to find a footing in the game while it's still within reach.
As Thomas gets up, gets a nice hand from the crowd. And as we see Prince Nardi getting set to come into the game for the Blue Hens. It'll be a Red Storm throw-in here with 23 minutes and 24 seconds left to go here in the first half. Storm have a 1-0 lead over the Blue Hens here in this NCAA tournament first round matchup. As I mentioned, the Blue Hens hosting their first NCAA tournament game in over 40 years. So, and the fans have heard about it, and more fans have been showing up during this first half. Now the line that was behind the Delaware goal is now extended almost all the way to the track. So it's a huge crowd here, probably a record crowd here for the Hens, as Prince Nardi checks in for the Hens, as well as number 13, Angus Maloney, for the Storm.
Yeah, this is a good move from Delaware here to bring Prince in. I think he's just going to bring a little bit more of an attack coming out of the back and really force the midfielders to kind of put more pressure on St. John's and those wide spaces where they're trying to cover with, you know, two or three guys. This is exactly what Prince does very well, which is kind of play the ball and get into the attack, which is, again, going to cause problems for St. John's if they don't cover their lines very well.
And Nardi replaced Di Rienzo. Blue Hens trying to mount an attack there. Stopped by the Red Storm, and now Storm on another attack. There's Mulligan. Mulligan with it now. Newell on defense. Played back to LeVay. Now to Albrecht. Albrecht looking to launch it forward. And that one's chipped over. And that one goes just wide. Off the foot of number 8, Danny Bedoya had a nice idea there.
A little miscommunication in the back there about who's following that run. It's a classic mistake of expecting the goalkeeper to come and get it or following them all the way into the box. Of course, in every circumstance, you want to make sure and you follow them regardless. If it's somebody making a run into that 18-yard box, you follow them regardless of what the goalkeeper's saying. And if he has to knock you out in order to get the ball, then that's what ends up happening.
So some rare miscommunication there between Barbero and his back line. Almost leads to a Red Storm goal. The fans right next to us, the Red Storm fans were already cheering for the goal. They thought it was going to go in. Went just wide right to the fortune of the Blue Hens. We're going to get a call here against the Hens. It'll be a free kick for the Storm. That ball played out wide. Excuse me, I misspoke earlier. Coming in for the Storm is number 13, Taylor Cole. Looking at the wrong roster. Ball's played in the middle for Mediate. Mediate, the long ball looking for Delgado. Diaz comes out. Ball goes back to the Storm. Now Martin has it for the Hens. Play back into Newell. Newell out to Nardi with Mulligan on defense. Nardi looking for somewhere to go with it. Good move there. Tries to sneak it through to Delgado.
Oh, go Kyle.
And Borden has some room now. Newell on defense. Borden looking to play a long ball into Seppi. Sampson cuts that one out. Sampson to Nardi. Good job using his body there.
That's great shielding the ball there from Prince. Good switch, good change of point of attack there.
Gary now with it. Albrecht on defense.
This is good build up here from Delaware.
And it was interesting. I thought we might have had a call there because everyone stopped running, but it turns out it was just an errant pass behind Delgado, and the ball now back with the Hens. Mueller taking his space up the middle, looking for Jimenez. Jimenez for Delgado. Nardi wins it back. Nardi falls. And he will get the call.
I agree with that. Yo,
call against Mulligan. It'll be a free kick now for the Hens. And Nardi is good on offense and defense, but the one statistical category he leads in is falls, I believe, this year. But it worked. He got the call, and the Blue Hens have a free kick. Newell will take it. That ball seemed to be behind everyone, but headed back into the middle. And it'll be a corner kick for the Blue Hens, their second of the night. So the Newell free kick ended up working. Now, is it designed to go that far out wide, or was he trying to put it into the middle and just kind of mishit it?
You know, it really just depends on what they've been working on the training ground. You know, if they've been practicing certain plays that they want to try to, you know, create some deception or, you know, get the St. John's crowd doing something in particular so that they can exploit a different area of the 18-yard box. But it's really hard to tell.
Nardi puts one in. Garrity was kind of held down there, couldn't quite get up to the ball. Mediate shielding. And Borden takes it away. Borden's got some room. Newell's hustling back on defense. Looking out wide for Bedoya. Bedoya, Martin, gets a foot on it. Beautiful dive from Ignacio Martin. And that ball will go out for a Red Storm throw-in. So Martin with possibly a goal-saving defensive play there.
Yeah, sometimes you just got to commit yourself to trying to win the ball back, especially in quick transition like that. Sometimes you don't have time to get the numbers back behind the ball. So you really have to just to try and make some sort of stoppage in the flow of the attack to get your team back in defensive shape.
Storm with it now. Play back to Bedoya. Garrity on defense. Ball back to the Hens. Jimenez looking to keep control of it. That ball goes off the shoulder of Albrecht. Good call there from the linesman. Ball goes back to the Hens. Jimenez with it now. Newell. Garrity. We've seen I don't know if it's the surface of the grass, but a lot of people are slip. A lot of athletes are slipping out there tonight.
Yeah.
Trying to make those quick moves.
Yeah. There's the field is definitely not playing as it usually would. In the prime of the season. So there's definitely a little bit of an acclimation to the way that this is playing right now for the players. I'm sure they would have, you know, practiced or had an opportunity to practice on the field the last couple days, but they still seem to be having a few issues keeping their feet.
Jimenez now with it. And maybe got a little bit of push from behind there. Ref didn't see it. Ball goes back to Nardi. Nardi back to Barbero. 17 minutes left to go here in the first half. The Storm still with a 1-0 lead as we see Joe Dupree warming up. That ball a little bit over the head of Delgado. 7 now with it. Plays it out wide. Bedoya now with it. Good defense there from Martin. Martinez now with it. Albrecht on defense. Martinez taking his space up the right side. Cuts it back in the middle. And nobody's there. So
yeah.
Martinez with a long run, but nobody at the end of that pass.
Yeah, you gotta find somebody there as you're kind of storming forward, and you've got the momentum going towards the goal, and you're in quick transition like that, and it's a quick counterattack. You know, really can't be wasteful. Playing balls to people who aren't there.
Looking for Delgado there. Cut out by Tim Parker, and that was a pretty easy one. Line judge goes up. Offsides call against the Storm. Free kick for Barbero and the Hens. Barbero looking for Garrity. That ball goes off the head of Cole. And we will see Joe Dupree come in. And he will check in for Mark Garrity. So Joe, the sophomore from England, checking back in.
Coach Hanno must really have some reservations about that left side, making his first two substitutions, two left-sided players. He must be wanting a little bit more than what he's getting right now, in terms of pressure from the left. So hopefully those two changes there are right what he's looking for. That's a sloppy giveaway right there.
The Hens now have their top four goal scorers on the field, all with over 12 points and 5 goals on the season. So maybe looking for a little more offense here. Martin. Looking up for Delgado. Cut out there by Bedoya.
Oh.
Ball goes out of play. It will go in the way of the Red Storm. 1-1 team and one fan base. I always think the refs made the right call.
That's the game.
Newell. Martinez now up the middle. Savino on defense. Now LeVay. Martinez still with it on his foot. Looking to Delgado. To Dupree. Dupree cutting in the middle. Over to Newell. Blue Ends trying to crack this defense. Dupree now with it still. A little give and go there. Dupree still fighting for it with Newell. And cut out there by Tim Parker. Parker using his 6'2 frame to really box out the much smaller Joe Dupree. Ball's back to Mueller. Up to Martin. Martin, all CAA second team selection this year. One of the 8 Blue Hens elected to an all CAA squad. Nardi using his speed now, coming up in the middle. Nardi still with it now. Albrecht pokes it away. That ball goes back to Newell. Newell and LeVay fighting for it. And that one's cut away by Seppi, it looked like.
Yeah, that's unfortunate.
Quick out there, Barbero. So just under 13 left to play here in the first half. The Storm still with a 1-0 lead over the Blue Hens. Dupree, Albrecht on defense. Seppi has it now. Up to Borden. Sampson on defense. Sampson and Nardi both going for him. Borden trying to get it in. Goes off the foot of Sampson. Will go out of play for a Red Storm throw-in. Miguel Alves checks back in for the Storm. The freshman from Newark, New Jersey.
You better get that right.
Yeah, you know, I'm from New Jersey, and I always said Newark, but now since I've been coming to Delaware, I say Newark, and I just can't figure it out. But he is from Newark, New Jersey. Freshman checking back in the game. He will replace Danny Bedoya. Nardi takes it away. Borden trying to keep it down his end. Mediate, launches it forward. Good ball there. Has Jimenez, if he can keep it in play, and he can. Jimenez still with it now. And they're going to say that ball went off of Jimenez. Ball goes back to the Storm. It'll be a throw-in. Long throw. Looking up for Martinez. Alves out to LeVay. Play back to Parker. Parker looking long for Borden. Cut out there by Sampson. The offsides flag goes up. It'll be a free kick now for the Hens. 11 minutes left to go here. Once again, thank you for spending part of your Thursday evening with us, the Hens All Access team. Alongside women's assistant head coach, Nitan Sony, I'm Kyle Coulter. It's been a lot of fun bringing you your Delaware men's soccer this season. Sad this will be the last home game. Hopefully not the last game for the Blue Hens. It's been a stellar season, the best in program history with 14 wins. But they're down right now to the Red Storm of St. John's. And we'll get Daniel Herrera and Jimmy Mulligan checking back into the game. And they will replace Marco Borden.
Yeah, that Marco had a very good game. I think he caused some problems there for... Well, he's had a good game so far. He's caused some problems here for Delaware, really looking to play on the backs of those defenders and looking for every opportunity to get in behind him. So he's caused some problems. I'm not I'm not exactly sure what these next two forwards are going to bring, but if it's any of the same, then we're Delaware's really going to have to be careful.
Sampson had the seemed like he was matched up with Borden a lot, and they had some good runs. But now some fresh legs coming back in for the Storm, and that is him right now, Herrera. Cut out there by Sampson. Newell with it now. Herrera takes it away, and Martin just has to clear it out of play. Be a throw in for the Red Storm.
I think one of the things that Coach Hanno is not going to be really pleased with, and probably make a point of talking to the guys at halftime, is really how much loss of possession Delaware have had in the middle of the field. You know, there's obviously certain areas of the field where you can afford a little bit more luxury with, you know, not completing passes or, you know, trying something that doesn't quite pull off. But in the middle of the field, that's definitely not one of them. And so I'm actually surprised that we've had a couple instances so far where we've been a little bit careless with the ball, not really taking care of it.
Yep, turnovers have definitely hurt the Hens so far in this match. Only have two shots so far on this night. Newell fighting for it with Herrera. Up to Mulligan. Mulligan has to be playing for it. Barbero's coming out. And Borja Barbero wisely comes out and kicks that one away.
Definitely needed the goalkeeper to intervene on that play.
That ball goes out of play. It'll be a Hens throw-in. And you mentioned the Blue Hens really needed to have like a good string of offensive attacks. Haven't really seen that yet. The Red Storm defense has been really compact. Haven't really been able to break them down. We might need to see another corner or a set piece to generate some offense here. That ball into Jimenez. Jimenez back to Delgado. Delgado in the middle with a shot. And that's knocked down by Diaz. Diaz handles it. So Delgado trying to get something going with that shot.
Good intricate passing there between the two forwards. Pretty opportunistic strike on goal. Trouble the goalkeeper, not really a great deal. He probably disappointed he didn't handle that a little bit better and had it come and spill out of his hands. But again, just something like that to lift the spirits here a little bit, bring some confidence to the game.
Newell's going to try a shot, and that tests Diaz once again. But the senior handles it. So Blue Hens trying to just generate some offense off shots, and they do there. That one a bit far out. Sampson plays it back to Barbero as we approach 7 minutes left to go here in the first half. It is standing room only here at Delaware Mini Stadium. Obviously more Blue Hens fans, but a lot of people have come down from New York to cheer on their Storm.
This is a very strong contingent coming from Jamaica, New York.
Herrera takes it. Herrera up the left side. Back to Albrecht. Played out to Cole. Back to Herrera. Nice little give and go there. Herrera still with it on his foot. Martin, cross. Sampson heads it away. No problem there for Ben Sampson. Another cross there. That one goes over the head of everyone. And Barbero will let it go out of play for a goal kick. So we mentioned this would be a very even matchup, and apart from that one corner, it really has been some stellar defense on the part of the Storm, as we mentioned pregame, that like it would be, and they've really silenced this potent Delaware offense so far, and they were able to get in that one crucial goal.
Yeah, they've done a good job of making the game predictable for themselves by working hard, putting numbers around the ball to press, and then allowing the players behind them to really find a good positioning, good primary and secondary defensive positioning to really limit the kinds of opportunities that Delaware is going to have. So, you know, we're going to have to go and revise possibly the way that we're looking at getting forward here for Delaware, and being a little bit more aggressive, and obviously being a goal down, you want to take a little bit more risk now. As the game continues to go on, you don't want to be in a situation where, you know, you're missing opportunities and not taking the chances that you need to be taking. So I would imagine at halftime there'll be some conversation about how they can be a little bit more direct and a little bit more aggressive, taking advantage of going forward.
As we saw Tobias Mueller there just picking up a yellow card, and it'll be a free kick from about 7 yards outside the 18 with 4:48 left to play here in the first half. Barbero setting up his defense. Looks like it'll be Herrera to take it. Herrera or Mulligan. Be Herrera with a shot! That ball goes just wide. So attempt on goal there, but seems like Barbero really had it tracked the whole time, but it might have deflected off of a Blue Hen defender maybe. It didn't seem like it did, but it might have caught a foot.
The referee's got the best pair of eyes on the field, supposedly.
That'll be a corner kick for the Storm. Daniel Herrera to take it. Cross into the middle. Samson heads it away. We're going to get a shot. Knocked away there by Newell. Jimenez running back to get it. Fighting with it with Herrera. Storm win it back. Played up for Mulligan. Samson is there with plenty of room. He'll play it wide to Martinez. With Savino on defense. Martinez and Savino still fighting for it. Martinez still with it on his foot. Jaime with some nice footwork, but good defense there from Albrecht to stay with it. And the ball goes back to the Storm.
It just doesn't seem to be enough people joining the attack from Delaware. You know, Red Storm's doing a great job of getting numbers back behind the ball like we've been talking about all half. Delaware really need to send more numbers up in the attack and really support those players as they go towards goal.
Really want to see Nardi and Mediate coming forward and getting in on the attack.
Yep, absolutely.
LeVay looking for Seppi. Cut out there by Mueller. 3 minutes left to go here in the first half. Dupree with it now. Dupree showing some speed. Out wide to Jimenez. They got two in the box. Jimenez looks like he might have been going for goal there. Newell has it now. Newell traps it. And that's cut out by Herrera. Storm looking to mount a counterattack here. Seppi. Nardi takes it away nicely. And Nardi taken down.
A word of warning there from the referee.
And there's a quick kick. It's got Delgado up the left side. Delgado crooked in that middle. The shot right at Diaz. Delgado had some space off the smart play from Nardi. Kind of catch the Storm defense sleeping, but couldn't quite capitalize on that opportunity.
Nice quick free kick there. Catches St. John's off guard a little bit. Gives him the time and space, the few yards that he needs to kind of position himself and get a quality strike on goal. I guess he might be a little bit disappointed that he didn't do a little bit better there.
Mueller and Savino fighting for it. Blue End still with it now. Newell. Dupree trying to do a give and go with Newell. Cut out by Herrera. Back up, he's got Delgado. And that one is poked away there at the last second by Kamara.
That's a very important interception there, just a little poke on the ball to take it out of the stride of Delgado, otherwise he was free.
Looking for Jimenez. Up the left side, Jimenez reverses field, reverses his track there. Goes back to Mediate. Savino's really causing some problems back there for the Hens, clearing. Mediate still with it.
People not too happy with that one.
Didn't seem that Mediate was particularly agreed with that call from the ref.
Yeah.
As we have 1 minute left to go here in the first half, the Storm probably take their time taking this free kick, I'd imagine. Kamara looking to mount a last minute attack there. That was a pretty errant free kick. Ball goes back to the Hens. They've got 40 seconds. Menez looking for Delgado. That one goes back to Diaz. Diaz boots it away as we 30 seconds left. Nardi heads it forward. And we're going to get a call there against Jimenez. He didn't pull out a card. I guess it was kind of even both ways. But once again, the Storm really getting the more of the four. And the card does come out against Jimenez. Looks like he's getting... elbows there when he's up in the air.
I think it's just something that the referee has to do at this point, since there's been two questionable, you know, elbows as they're going up competing. It may not be nothing, you know. Best policy is just keep your eye on the ball and go straight forward, straight up, and you know. But in this game, when there's so much on the line, you know, you want to make sure that you're being first to the ball, and so you know, players naturally use their elbows to try to elevate them that extra inch, the extra 2 inches to kind of win the ball first, and consequently, you leave yourself open for some fouls against you.
And so Jimenez and Mueller both have to be careful now with each a yellow card. As we have 10 seconds left to go here. Looking for Seppi. And I think that'll do it here for the first half from Delaware Mini Stadium. We're going into the break with the Red Storm of St. John's up 1-0 over your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. Coach, thoughts at halftime. Thoughts at half here.
Yeah, I think Delaware need to go into their halftime break, just trying to settle themselves a little bit, really pull out some real positive plays in the game, and I'd like to see them go a little bit bigger. Everything they've been doing so far is very intricate, very kind of close range. Really haven't caused too many problems for St. John's. I'd really like to see St. John's be stretched a little bit more and really being able to capitalize on quick opportunities to not really allow St. John's to get back behind the ball, which is definitely where their defensive strength comes from, is getting numbers back behind the ball and then hunting the ball down. If Delaware can find those opportunities quickly and attack very quickly while stretching them at the same time, I think there might be some opportunities in this game for Delaware to see many, many opportunities.
So the Blue Hens have got the horses. We'll see if Coach Hennessy lets them out of the stable, so to speak, as he talks to his team at halftime. We're going to take a quick break, but don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with the second half here on Hens All Access.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Blue Hens Beat. I'm Scott Klatskin.
And I'm Jimmy Smith. Coming up in today's show, Scott will treat us to a Blue Hens sports update. Quarterbacks coach John Perry, he'll show you how to throw the perfect spiral. And we feature the University of Delaware's focus on giving back to the community.
But first, Delaware field hockey had quite the season, winning the regular season and CAA tournament title, beating Liberty in the NCAA tournament, and then putting together a good showing against third-ranked North Carolina. Hens All Access reporters Ben Evangelista and Kyle Coulter profiled the team's change of culture on and off the field.
So, Coach, brought in a lot of new foreign talent the last couple years, and two of which are leading the team in points. Talk about their impact on the team.
Now, all the players on the team have an impact within our team setting. We are fortunate that an Esme and an Ayla are the ones that put the numbers in that the statistics show. They have been playing a little longer than some of our domestic players. But it's a great balance, and they feed off of each other, and we get it done together. So, yes, they are from abroad, but at the end of the day, we play Delaware hockey here, and then we do it together. So, good things are happening right now in Newark.
So, Mariella, I heard everyone on the team calls you MJ, so I'm just going to call you MJ if that's okay. So you were born in the Netherlands, and you came over here with Esme as well. You're the two freshmen on the team, both from the Netherlands. So talk about you and her, as well as Ayla, and how you've been able to change the culture of the team this season.
I think it's a combination of like how the culture was here and how we bring in things. They have like American qualities and like the how much they enjoy playing field hockey and how much they spend time on it. And we have our things from the Netherlands and from Germany we bring in. We have skills with ball and stick, and I think the combination of that like makes a culture that's like very great to have success.
The American culture is already that everybody is working very hard, and I think that's also the point in this season. And since we win a lot of games, the atmosphere in the team is really good, and that helps during practice and also with games. Everybody is working hard and everybody wants to be better, and therefore I think we can help them with some technical stuff, but I think that the American people are better in mental and they've all a really good condition, so I think we can help each other good in the team, and that works.
So it's a good give and take.
Yeah, it works really good.
So Ayla, you're first on the team in points as a sophomore. You're leading the team in goals, native of Germany. What are your thoughts of how you and the other two have contributed to the team this year?
I think along with like American work ethic and their like athleticism, we like brought in a lot more skills. And I think if you combine that together, that like makes a good team, and that's where we are right now.
Well, MJ or Marielle and Esme have been a great addition to our team. They bring a lot of energy and just fun, relaxed kind of Dutch casualness about them. But it's always great to have international girls. You know, they make everything funnier, just in silly things that they just the interpreting the language and playing with them. But also they bring a different spirit to our team and a different intensity, which we really value and appreciate. But it's been really fun. You know, their English has improved so much. And really, I give them a lot of credit for coming over here, handling schoolwork, and then on top of that, playing a sport with girls who have a completely different language. And they've done an excellent job, and give them a lot of credit for that.
So what was the biggest culture shock coming over here for you?
The biggest culture shock was, well, the language is like the biggest difference. Like when we have conversations and they're like jokes, you want to laugh about it, but you don't understand them. So you're like, okay, what am I supposed to do now? That was like the hardest part.
You only visited the USA once before coming to Delaware, and you just told me that it was on the West Coast. So what made you choose the University of Delaware?
I was interested in this university because the field hockey plan makes sense and they want to build up in they want to make the team better, and I was like, okay, I want to be a part of that, and yeah, I want to learn stuff, and yeah, I want to be a part of the program. Here, some things are more serious, and it's more extreme, like, especially the locker room. We have our own locker room, and in the Netherlands, you've just a club team, and there is one locker room for all the teams, so, and here also, we're traveling, we're sleeping in hotels, we have dinner with each other, and it's so much more, I don't know.
It's so much, a lot more camaraderie between the team, because you're together all the time, right?
Yeah.
Has it been interesting having two players from your homeland on the team?
I can, it's myself talking Dutch from time to time, but other than that, it's just, they are two great players like everybody else we have on our team, and the synergy that we are able to create with people from different states, from different countries is phenomenal, and it's going to allow everybody in this program, Friendships for Life.
Thanks, Kyle. With one of the best regular season records in recent history, as well as a slew of international talent and strong upperclassmen leadership, the Blue Hens are poised to make a strong run into the playoffs and hopefully put another number on the banner behind me.
All right, welcome back to Blue Hens Beat. I'm quarterback coach John Perry, and I'm here with Trent Hurley. We're going to show you how to throw the perfect spiral. What we do here is we teach the quarterbacks to throw. Everything starts from having a good base. So as Trent shows you how to throw the ball, he has to have a good base. It's going to work up through. For him to create momentum, what he's going to do is open his hip towards his target. He's going to drive his hips through to the target. As he drives his hips through the target, now he has to bring the ball up. We want to make sure his elbow is above his shoulder. As he comes through, he's going to drive his front elbow down, so that will create force for his back, his throwing shoulder to come through. The key to the throwing the perfect spiral is making sure that the last finger to leave the ball will be his index finger, and he wants to make sure he flicks his wrist, drive the ball through, snap his wrist, thumb down, palm out, making sure his index finger is the last to leave the ball. That is how we throw the perfect spiral.
It's time for the Blue Hen Sports Update. The number 14 Delaware field hockey team held its own against number 3 North Carolina in the NCAA tournament, but UNC handed the Blue Hens a 6-2 loss to bring a successful season to a close. The loss ended one of the most memorable seasons in Delaware history as the Blue Hens earned a CAA tournament championship, an NCAA preliminary round win over Liberty, and finished the season with a 17-5 record. Football now, as the Hens were dealt a tough loss on Senior Day in a wild CAA game that saw Richmond top Delaware 46-43. After the Blue Hens had taken their first lead of the day on an 11-yard run by Andrew Pierce, with just 45 seconds left to play, Richmond drove 75 yards and captured the victory on a 3-yard pass with just 4 seconds left. Delaware will look to close out the regular season with a win and make a strong impression on the NCAA Tournament Selection Committee when the Hens travel to PPL Park in Chester, Pennsylvania to take on longtime rival Villanova Saturday at 3:30 p.m. Women's hoops got a huge win over ACC foe Wake Forest 71-61. On a night when the team honored its glorious past, the Blue Hens got a nice look at its promising future. Senior forward Kelsey Buchanan led the way with 22 points and 9 rebounds, and freshman guard Erica Brown scored 18 points. Delaware will return to action Tuesday, November 19th, when the Hens host Monmouth at 7 p.m. Volleyball battled down to the end, but it wasn't enough as the Blue Hens closed out an uncharacteristic 2013 season with a 3-0 loss to league-leading College of Charleston. Delaware finished the season with an 11-17 overall record and a 7th place finish in the CAA with a mark of 3-11. The perennial CAA power Blue Hens, who featured a young lineup that included 11 freshmen and sophomores, suffered their first losing season since 2005. Men's basketball finally, as Jarvis Threet scored 27 points while Kyle Anderson added 24 as the Hens posted a 90-79 road victory at Hampton. Senior forward Carl Baptiste set his career best for the second consecutive game with 15 points on the afternoon, while sophomore Marvin King Davis, making his first career start, tied his career high with 8 points. Delaware's back on the road Tuesday with a 7 p.m. tilt at Armin. Now here's a look at the upcoming schedule.
We're going to toss it down to sideline reporter Jen DeLuca, who's standing by with former player Bill Dodds. Jen?
VCU 0, Navy 0.
He was on the team that hosted the last
second half.
Yeah.
Second game. Bill, tell us about the excitement tonight. Crowd is full. There's people standing along the fence. Tell us about this.
Well, it's a great experience to be here tonight and see the number of people. We didn't have quite this big of crowds back in 1970, but we had a decent crowd. Also, the field is beautiful now. I mean, our field was not quite this nice with the grass and everything like that in 1970. One of the big changes is we only played 11 regular season games in 1970. So we were 9-0-2. I think we weren't the only undefeated team in Delaware history in the regular season. We played Penn State on this field, and we had a 1-0 lead, and in the last like 20 minutes they scored 2 goals. They scored the last goal with like 2 minutes left, beat us 2-1.
Well, I know about your relationship with Coach Hennessy. I hope you got to catch up with him before the game. So you said you come to a lot of games. Tell me how Coach Hennessy has got you along these past couple of years, bringing you back to the Blue Hen Stadium.
Coach Hennessy, when he became the head coach, reached out to the alumni right away, and he had a couple events down here. And in 2008, I had put together a reunion of the 1968 and 1970 NCAA teams. We had two teams that made it, 68 and 70. I was a freshman in 68, and freshmen couldn't play back then, so I didn't play on the 68 team. One of the best players on that team in the Hall of Fame is Mike Biggs, who may be watching tonight, so I want to give a shout out to Mike Biggs, who was a captain of the 1970 team. What was the question again?
How's Coach Hennessy? So
he's really reached out to the alumni and done a lot of stuff to help us come back into the program, and it's been really fun to feel like we're a part of it again, and a lot of the old Blue Hens are back to cheer on the Blue Hens of today.
Well, that's awesome. As an alumni, what do you expect of your Blue Hens tonight on the field?
Well, I want to see 2 goals in the second half, and I think they can do it. They look like they're ready to put something together here. They started pushing at the end of the first half, and that's what we're looking for.
All right, well, thanks so much for joining us. Back to you guys.
Thank you.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, Jen and Bill. We are just about 2 minutes and 20 seconds away from the start of the second half here at Delaware Mini Stadium. Once again, thank you for joining us here on Hens All Access. Alongside Nitan Soni, I'm Kyle Coulter. It's a rough first half for the Hens. Both teams even with shots, both teams either with corner kicks. But the real story was that one goal coming off the foot of Gabriel Camara, his first of the season. They gave the assist to Danny Bedoya, who's the one who took the corner. And it was it had a lot of pace on it. Barbero got both hands onto it, but it still found its way into the back of the net. And St. John's has had many opportunities in this game. The Blue Hens started pushing more towards the end. Haven't really gotten any solid chances yet. What would you want to see coming out of the Blue Hens in the second half?
Yeah, just like we talked about just before the break, I'd really like to see the Blue Hens go a little bit bigger and really stretch St. John's to really open up spaces between their lines, between their players, to really open up some more space. I think what they're currently doing, it's tight. I think they're relying on a lot of quick one-touch movement, which has paid off dividends for them throughout the season. But against this St. John's team, they need to be a little bit more direct and really find those opportunities and catch them out of shape and out of position so that they can build something out of that. I think if they're coming off probably the best period of the first half for them in the last 5 minutes of the first half. So that will bode well for them going into the second. But see if they can change things up a little bit. Again, they're a goal down, they're chasing back. You know, at this point in the season, it's do or die. It's leave it all out in the field. So take a little bit more risk. I think that can be calculated enough to prevent yourself from really going 3 or 4 behind.
And we will see if the game plan changes at all here for the Hens. They need to change something because their offense, one of the best offenses in the country, has been pretty much shut down by this Red Storm defense. And as we mentioned earlier, both these teams have been working since February, January, March, and it all comes down to this. As a high school coach once told me, you have three seasons, the preseason, the regular season, the postseason. And once you get into the postseason, everyone's record is wiped clean. Everything you did before that, it doesn't matter. It's all how you play in this do-or-die situation. And we are here. Both teams have retaken the field to start the second half. And we're looking forward to some more soccer here on Hens All Access.
There's certainly a lot more soccer to play in this game. Scoreline is very close. You know, it's definitely got the makings of having a spectacular second half.
The Blue Hens no stranger from coming from behind. Their last game, which they lost in penalty kicks to Drexel in the CAA semifinals. They were down 2-0 at halftime and ended up coming back and tying that game in the 85th minute. So you never know what you're going to see here from this Blue Hens team. They're a resilient bunch, even though they're very young, but they have a lot of toughness and a lot of resiliency. And we'll hopefully see that here in the second half. And the Storm just looking to keep on doing what they're doing. I would assume they played a very solid first half, which you would expect from a team that's still playing this late in the season. And really, the Delaware has had a lot of soccer success this season. Both the men's and women's club soccer team are playing in nationals right now down in Phoenix. So good luck to them. I'm sure they'd be here cheering on their boys if they were here. And that ball cut out there by Alves. Alves looking for Albrecht. As we see Borden back in the game. Borden, who had a very strong first half. Martinez up the right side now. LeVay on defense. Martinez looking to the middle. And that ball a little bit behind Jimenez. Up to Borden. Cut out there nicely by Tobias Mueller, who received a yellow card in the first half, along with Roberto Jimenez, so they're both going to have to be careful here in the second half. Ball played up forward for Joe Dupree. Dupree's got Delgado. Delgado trying to go to his left foot. Seemed like he had enough room to take a shot there. Tried to push it over to his left foot, and it just got taken away there by Parker.
Yeah, just got caught up there. It's unfortunate. Good attacking movement there. I like the fact that the Delaware have come out and wanted to claim the style of the game that they want to play and impose that on St. John's. If they can keep that up for 45 minutes, anything can happen.
And we mentioned earlier a statistic that after when scoring first, the Storm since 2010 are 41-1 after scoring the first goal, and this season they are 9-0-1. So they're tough to beat when they get a lead. But if there's any team that could come back, it's definitely these Blue Hens with the tied for the most goals in the country. And the Storm typically score more of their goals in the second half, as well as the Blue Hens. So both two teams, second half teams, the Hens pressing early here. Martinez, nice play into Delgado. Cut up by Parker once again. The Hens still pressing here, Martin. Play back to Delgado. Delgado leading the team with 14 goals on the season. Sampson coming up from his back line. Out wide to Dupree. Dupree still with it on his foot. Play back to Nardi.
That's a little bit better from Delaware. Really exploiting the width of the field. Opening things up.
Martinez in the
middle. That's a handball! Oh!
And they were looking for a handball from the ref. We saw it. The fans did not like the call, especially Jaime Martinez was irate on the field right now. The Blue Hens still have the ball, though. Up across in the middle.
It looked like there was some contact there. Again, referee had a better view of it than we did, and he made the call. Or didn't make the call.
That ball cleared away by Diaz. But the Blue Hens, more pressure in these first 3.5 minutes than we saw most of the first half.
Yeah, this is much better. The first two or three attacks coming from big switches from right to left, left to right, from the back to the forward or back to the wide positions. I think that's going to serve Delaware a lot better than possibly really trying to play intricate soccer right through the middle.
Some nice passing there in the midfield, but couldn't connect with the forwards. As the ball goes to Alves, snap ball back to Sampson. Dupree, he's got Delgado.
He's got some opportunities to get forward.
Martinez.
Get wide and forward, here we go.
Jimenez looking up the right side. Caught up a little bit there with Martinez, has to backtrack. Jimenez, and that ball is booted out of play.
Good, this is much better from Delaware.
Martin, cross it in the middle, and Diaz comes over and gets it.
That is a giant frame, especially when it's leaping through the air like that. I mean,
Diaz, the redshirt senior, only 6 foot, but it seemed like he was 6'4" there as he got up.
That was a big body to be flying through the air.
Martin is there. Alves working on him. Throw back to Mueller. Sampson now looking to clear it. Mediate, just has to play it back to Barbero. Barbero launches it forward. Seems that Borja has kind of gave up on No Shave November. He had the pretty raging beard going. Seems like he cut it for the NCAA tournament. So, and we're going to call there against the Storm. Be a free kick for the Hens. Mueller will take it. Be interesting to see if we see Mark Garrity back in this game. He got taken out by Joe Dupree earlier in the first half. He's a big scoring threat. And he seems to come up with clutch goals. He's done that all season, the senior captain. And we'll see if we see him later in this half. Martin. Jimenez loses it, but gets it right back. Martin now has it. And we mentioned earlier we'd like to see the Blue Hens kind of push some men forward. And Martin, the defenseman, crosses it forward into the middle. And that ball goes over the head of Delgado, and Diaz grabs it.
Yeah, I think Delaware asking a lot more questions of the goalkeeper and the back line of the St. John's this early period of the second half. Very good to see that.
Fought four in the middle. Nardi has it now. Nardi plays it forward to Delgado. Delgado working it back into the middle. He's looking for Jimenez. That ball goes just far. Nice try there from Delgado. Diaz now with it as we're just at 7 minutes gone by here in the second half. The Storm still with a 1-0 lead over the Blue Hens. Once again, thank you for joining us tonight here on Hens All Access. Alongside Neaton Sony, I'm Kyle Coulter. Borden up the left side. Martin and Mediate on defense. Back to Herrera in the middle for Albrecht. Albrecht with some nice footwork there. Plays it out to Herrera.
Again, good pressure on the ball like we saw early in the first half from Delaware. Chasing the ball, hunting the ball, forcing those errors, waiting for that mistake, and then trying to capitalize on possession.
That ball goes out of play off. The Storm will go back to the Hens. Martin with it. Martin still back to Mueller. Jimenez now trying to shield it.
This is much better with interplay between the midfielders and the forwards from Delaware. Definitely causing some problems here.
That ball a little bit off the mark there from Martinez. Sampson with it now. Decides to just play it back to Barbero. Borden giving chase. It's always a little nerve-wracking there when you see the keeper handling it. But Barbero, the junior, is well-seasoned at that. Delgado with some speed now up the middle. Trying to cut it back. He's trying to get some room for his right foot.
Oh, here it is.
He's got Here's Martinez. Martinez on the right side. Looking in the middle, and that ball couldn't find Jimenez. Cut out there by the Storm.
That's a great ball out wide. Really, really opens up the 18-yard box.
Newell shielding himself.
Again, stretching the St. John's team here. Working out in Delaware's favor, especially not trying to play those tight little plays inside the 18 six-yard box, opening them up, stretching them out, and really causing some problems.
It's a long ball looking for looking for Dupree. Up to Borden. Borden's got two guys on him. No call there. Taken away by Mediate. Nardi with it now. That ball's booted away by, it looked like, Cole. Ball goes back to Barbero, goes out of bounds. Be a throw-in for the Hens. And a huge crowd here on hand to watch this NCAA tournament match.
Great support. It's an excellent way to showcase our school and the support that we have for our fellow athletic programs. Great support from everybody out here today. Certainly local community groups. A lot of local soccer clubs here today. Great to see.
I'm sure if you're a young soccer player around this area, you got to come watch these guys. They played so well all season and really get a good model for what it's like to play soccer at the most elite level besides the pro. Besides professional soccer, and it's got to be fun for them.
Yeah, and it's unfortunately one of the things I don't think happens a lot in the United States is, you know, young people who are excited and invested in the game not playing enough. I've seen so many times where talented players will really miss a beat. Here we go with an attack here. Again, trying to find that wide player, stretching out the St. John's defense. That's really what we're going to need to see from Delaware. If they keep at it, they might be fortunate enough to connect one of these passes and get the goal that they need to get them back in this game.
Mueller, back to Barbero. Martinez, nice one touch out to Martin. Martin, beautiful ball there up to Jimenez. Parker's on defense, and Parker just kicks it out of play. It'll be a throw-in for the Hens.
Some good pace from that center back.
Tim Parker has been playing really nice defense so far for the Storm tonight.
Yeah, pretty
and there's
solid.
A nice ball to Jimenez. Nice cross to the middle. Kicked away by Diaz. Nardi has it now on the left side.
It's Menes important to stay patient. It's
Nardi with
to stay
it now.
Patient.
Nardi's gonna take a shot.
It's like a deflection. Did he take a deflection? Nope. Okay.
And Nardi gets a little too much, leans a little too far back, ball sails over the cage. Jimenez had the best shot at it, though, was trying to cross it right across the goal line. Kicked away really nicely there by Diaz. Goalie made a really nice play on that.
That's a very crowded 6-yard box when the defensive players from St. John's kind of drop and kind of cover that the frame of the goal. Makes it very difficult to really see anything. And then on top of that, you got 6-foot goalkeeper that stretches out like a cartoon character, and he's able to stretch the full width of the goal. So, but I think this is a great spell. Again, a great spell from Delaware. Good first 15 minutes or so into the second half.
Good cut out there from Martin as we see Josh Godick and Danny Bedoya check back in for, oh, and some physical play there from the Storm. Ball goes out of play.
I don't think there's anything in that. It's just a shoulder-to-shoulder bump. And
Tim Parker just seems to be a lot bigger than Martinez.
Yeah,
so
that's
it.
That's
it was just
what
really just
say.
A weight thing there. I didn't think it was anything malicious. Jimenez still with it now. Cross in the middle.
Oh.
Kicked away. Ball goes back to the Hens. It'll be a throw-in from Martin. 13 minutes gone by here in the second half. A lot of the Blue Hens fans on their feet. Looking for something big here off this throw-in. Martin. Plays into the corner, back to Martin. The cross into the middle. Blue Hens will maintain possession. Delgado has it.
Just a lot more, people involved in the attack from Delaware now.
Good touch there from Martin, and it goes right back to the Storm, but it goes out of play off the foot of Albrecht. Nice catch there. Ball goes back to Mueller. Played there by Bedoya, whose corner kick set up the lone goal of this match so far for the Storm. And it seems like we really haven't seen anything offensively from the Red Storm so far this second half. It's been mostly played in the midfield and on the Delaware's offensive half, and it's a very different pace of play here from the Hens coming out. And you would wonder if that's part of the Blue Hens pressing more and also the Storm kind of sitting back and making sure they don't let up a goal.
Yeah, I think it could, you know, the beginning of games can be so vital in kind of predicting how the rest of the game is going to go. I mean, sometimes you find yourself in the defensive shape. You know, you maintain that defensive shape for a lot longer than you should. It's quality of a good team that can really bounce from a defensive shape to an offensive shape, you know, as quick as the game changes. But I think in this particular circumstance here, in the first 15 minutes, you know, we've got St. John's in a bit of a defensive shape here, keeping him that way, and Delaware being able to capitalize on a very good offensive period here.
Martinez taking up space on the right side. Looking up to Jimenez. LeVay is on defense. Jimenez looking to go around the right side. Still fighting for it, shielding it. There's just a nice footwork back to Martinez. To Jimenez. Take it to the middle. For Newell. Into the middle. For Dupree. Still, Hens still have a chance now. Parker takes it away.
Get a lot of bodies. A lot of bodies in that box. It's going to be hard to really, you're going to have to be very precise and very accurate to find those feet, but almost dropping there for Delaware. Had a good shot. Oh.
Nardi with another opportunity. And take another shot. Deflected there. And the Storm with it now. So a barrage of attempts there from the Hens. Kept getting knocked away there by the Storm defense. Played out to LeVay. LeVay still with it. Out wide for Cole.
I think this might be the first time that St. John's been able to string, you know, 3 or 4 passes in a row since the beginning of the second half.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. We haven't really seen, as we mentioned, the Storm really able to set up an offense at all. They've been mostly under attack through the first 17 or so minutes of this first half. of the second half, excuse me. Parker now with it. Looking forward. He's got Bedoya. Bedoya still with it now.
Oh, dear. Right, that's an unlucky.
A little miscommunication
unlucky
there.
Bounce
cross
here
in the middle. Headed away there by Martin. Barbero running for it. Barbero with it now. He tries to boot it away. He's got to get back in cage. Martinez just got to hold it. Gives it away back to Albrecht. Mueller with it now. Mueller fighting for it with Godek up to Jimenez. Jimenez, good footwork there. Jimenez still with it now and fighting for it. Going to get a call there against Jimenez. Hopefully the ref doesn't pull out another yellow card. Jimenez got his first yellow card in the first half, so he's got to be careful here. That didn't look like it really warranted a call.
I mean, that's a tough one. If that catches anybody, you know, that's going to hurt someone. So I can understand the referee wanted to play a little bit cautious there on that challenge.
Seemed like he was going for the ball, though. It
didn't
seem
like
there was
I don't believe there's any intent or any kind of, you know, malice involved. But you just got to be careful. And as emotions run high, you're chasing the game, and you feel like the tempo is definitely going in your favor. You want to keep your emotions in check and make sure you're still playing the game the way it's supposed to be played.
Especially such a pressure-packed game here this first round of the NCAA tournament. The Storm making their 20th program appearance. The Blue Hens only their fourth. Bedoya. Bedoya tries to chip it through, and the offsides flag is up. And we will get the offsides call.
It's important that Delaware get back into their rhythm now. It's very important they get back into their early rhythm that they found in the second half. Not really let St. John's on the ball for too long periods of the game that's remaining. Really being able to put a stamp on how the second half is going to go.
Parker with it now. Lofts it up. Martin heads it. Back to Alves, Albrecht, and good footwork there. We've got Godek. Godek at the left side. Tobias Mueller on defense. Godek looking to cross
good defense, good
it
defense.
And gets a corner for the Storm. It'll be their third of the night. Their first two corners, they've each had chances. Of course, their first corner, they scored their lone goal. So the Blue Hens really got to step it up here. Can't afford any miscommunication or fall for any trickery like they did from the first corner.
Yeah, hopefully they've learned from the first corner from where they conceded, and they're going to be a little bit more alert to this one and subsequent corners in the game.
Ball's put into the middle. Back to Bedoya. Bedoya's going to take a shot. And Barbero gobbles that one up. Looking to start a quick attack. Boots it forward. Albrecht cuts that one out. Coach Hennessy kind of put his arms up. Not really sure where that one was going. Albrecht crosses fields over to Cole.
Yeah, Delaware not pressing as high as they were in the first half. It could very well be because of the emotions of the game in the first 15-20 minutes of the first half, but certainly their strikers happy to kind of wander around, drift in the middle of the field, and be supplied by the midfielders who are then, you know, supporting the attack by getting forward also, which is proving to be positive.
Jimenez still with it now. Jimenez up to Delgado, trying to do a little give and go there. But the Storm have really been on that play all night from the Hens. As Ben Sampson cuts that one out. Up to Nardi. Cannot keep it in play. Ball goes back to the Storm. 24 minutes left to go here in the second half. Once again, fans, remember you can follow the Hens on Twitter at twitter.com/UDBlueHens. Get live stats, updates, as well as pictures and videos. Also become a fan on Facebook at facebook.com/BlueHens. Post-game videos, highlights, recaps, pictures, and much more. That's at facebook.com/BlueHens. And we see Nick DiRienzo, who started the game, warming up on the sidelines. Looks like he's about to check back in. He was replaced by Nardi earlier in the first half. Looks like we'll see the sophomore back in this game. As Martin chases it out wide. Mueller with it. Duane's just trying to clear it. Storm putting a lot of pressure on.
Much better movement there from Delaware.
Hey, let's go, LeVay. Let's go, LeVay.
Mueller's trying to keep it. Ball will go back to the Storm. It'll be a St. John's throwing.
Let's go, Delaware.
Come on, Blue Hens.
LeVay, big throw, looking for Godek. Ball's played back into Sampson. Played back to Barbero. Oof. Barbero's just got a booted away. It goes out of play on the pressure from Alves. Throwing from Storm.
So exchange of words between the referee and the coach from St. John's there, interested to know what that was about.
Martin and Mueller combined to cut that one out.
Oh, that's a good call.
When he had a call there against Gabriel Camara on Guillermo Delgado. Mediate with it. Mediate thought about taking a quick one, but he's going to take his time. Plays it over to Sampson. Blue one's looking to just cross it over the midfield line for the first time in 5 minutes or so. Back to Newell. Nardi keeps it in play.
Oh, good. There we go.
Dupree has it now. Up the left side. Dupree using the speed. Crosses into the middle. There seems like there should have been a runner there. Jimenez was kind of hanging back.
Yeah. It's important they don't get caught ball watching. We definitely want to get people up in the game.
And no call there against Nardi.
This is where they're going to be.
Here's Mulligan.
This is where they're going to be exposed, Delaware, when they get so many numbers up in the attack, and St. John's are able to get the ball up quickly. It's really going to leave them exposed.
Jaime Martinez. Play back to Martin. Out to Sampson. Nardi. Good pass up to Dupree. Dupree comes, takes it back into the middle. Dupree's going to take a shot!
Oh.
Tess Diaz, but a nice save there from the keeper. Didn't really have to move laterally, just vertically.
Yeah, I mean,
he was able to get his hands on that.
This keeper covers a lot of that goal. I think it's, if his vertical was 3 or 4 inches lower and he was himself about 4 inches smaller, like that one. Someone creeps into the goal. Oh,
the ball's lost there.
Silly mistake at the back there.
Bedoya falls. Newell picks it up. You mentioned this, the St. John's keeper, Rafael Diaz, having one of his best seasons. He has 9 shutouts on the year, giving up less than a goal a game, and is second among active goalkeepers in the nation with 32 career shutouts. Jimenez up the right side.
It's a lot of good work there by Jimenez.
Back to Martinez. Martinez with 2 Storm defensemen on him. Martinez looking to cross it, and it goes right to Diaz. Blue Hens fans just kind of waiting to get out of their seats and cheer for something, you know?
Yeah. Good wide play there from Delaware.
Ball goes back to Martin. Martin just got to put it up, looking for mediate. Martinez does a nice job. And no call against the Red Storm. The ref was kind of shielded there from that. We saw a bit of a jersey tug, but I think the fall was more theatrics than anything.
Yeah,
but.
Yeah, I mean, the referee's close enough to use good judgment there on what he feels like is happening. But certainly, didn't help himself out.
Martinez up to Delgado. Delgado cannot keep it in play. Once again, Parker right there on his hip. We're going to get some substitutions coming in for the Red Storm. Number 23, Jordan Rouse, and number 25, Sean Seppi, checking back into the game. Also, we will see Nick DiRienzo checking back in. He replaces Vincent Mediate. Mediate, who playing in this game, increases his Blue Hens record of most games played. He's now 76 in his career here. That's most by any Blue Hen men's soccer player.
It's a pretty impressive statistic.
Yeah. Cut out there by the Storm.
So we're approaching a very important period of the game right now, when there's 20 minutes or so left of the game is really where, if you're going to make significant changes, if you're really going to make significant changes, this is where you want to do it, because this gives enough time for the players to adjust and really put in place enough pressure to get back the goal that they're chasing.
And now we're going to see another substitution for the Blue Hens. Dieter Barr, a sophomore from Bowlesburg, Pennsylvania, checking in. He will take out Joe Dupree. Interesting substitution there. Barr played in only 8 games this season. But he's getting some crucial playing time here, as you mentioned.
Some important minutes being played right now.
Yep. Barbero. DiRienzo now.
Again, St. John's trying to make this game very predictable.
Jimenez now. Parker on defense. Played out wide to Barr. Barr lets it go through to Nardi.
Good. A lot of bodies in the box now.
Nardi's looking to cross it in.
Oh!
Just over the head of Delgado. The Storm tries to clear it. They do. Back out to Newell. Newell.
They need to be patient. They need to be patient. Not get caught up in the frantic nature of the attack and really be patient. Oh,
Martinez was able to save it. Tried to cross it in, but Diaz is right there. So Gamble Delgado was maybe a couple inches taller. He would have seen something else there. But that ball goes just over the head of the freshman. Barr is able to keep it in. And that ball goes out of bounds. They're going to say it's touched Barr last. It'd be a throw-in for St. John's, as we're just under 15 and a half left to go here in regulation. Come on, Delaware! Fans, also remember to check out Blue Hens Beat, our bi-weekly web show dedicated to everything Delaware athletics. Gives you the behind-the-scenes look you need on every Delaware sports team. We had a new one come out on Monday, so check that out on Hens All Access. That's Blue Hens Beat. There's Jimenez at the left side. Couldn't tell if that was a shot or
I think he's trying to serve the ball in there, but got to keep plugging away.
Just under 15 minutes left to go here. Blue Hens desperately trying to tie this game up. The winner of this game will go down to Charlottesville on November 24th to take on University of Virginia in the second round. You know, these two teams got kind of an unfortunate draw. They're in the same corner of the bracket with the number 1 overall seed, UCLA. So if they continue to win, they will eventually meet up with them.
And that's a Delaware ball. It's a Delaware ball.
Clutch play there from Martin, poking that away from Seppi. Ball played into Newell. Taken away there.
That's a tough ball to kind of bring down right from the throw in there. Really wasn't in the best position to receive it.
Martin into Newell. Played out wide to Nardi. Delgado with it now. Delgado using his speed, trying to get into the middle.
Little width. Good. Great.
Martinez, can he get to it? He can. Fans are standing up here. Martinez crosses in the middle.
That
one goes just behind Delgado and Jimenez running. Ball goes out of play. It'll be a Red Storm throw, and as we see Vincent Mediate stretching out once again, we might see the senior check back into the game. Be a throw in here coming from Albrecht. Play back to LeVay. The ball goes over the head.
Oh.
Cut out there by Seppi. But Mueller's able to get back in front of that one. Played
good.
Out to Barr. Using his space up the left side.
Oh.
A little too far there.
A little heavy feet.
Looking for Delgado. Seems like the Blue Hens are just not in sync right now, just missing each other on these runs. That ball's booted away by Diaz. Sampson heads it forward. That ball's chipped forward. Looking for Rouse. Cut in the middle. Cut out there by Nardi. Just wasn't enough Red Storm members to really mount that attack.
Yeah, I think they're playing a very conservative second half. I mean, I don't want to take anything away from Delaware. They've certainly capitalized on the opportunities to get forward. But Red Storm happy to kind of bunker down and commit very few people forward. You obviously saw only two people going into the attack there. Basically paying it up to the forwards and letting them do what they got to do while others kind of drift around, not necessarily being engaged in that particular attack. So it's really important that Delaware find that one opportunity that's going to get them the goal they need.
We're going to see a substitution. It will be Vincent Mediate checking back into the game.
Number 18, Vincent Mediate.
And he will come in for Kyle Newell. Newell gets a nice hand as he leaves the field. Played a good game today. Didn't really call his name much in the second half. Seemed like he wasn't really around the action much.
Yeah, I mean that might be the reason for the change there from Coach Hennessy.
Put up the bar.
He's played some solid minutes today and certainly made his fair share of contributions this season. So I'm sure he'll be pleased with what he's been able to do so far this year. Let's hope he has another opportunity to get out there.
Ball goes back to DiRienzo. Back to DiRienzo now. Looking for Delgado in the middle. Played out to Sampson. Barr. Back to Sampson. Sampson moving it up over to Barr. Nardi now with it, trying to shield the ball, trying to cut it back into the middle. And once again, it's cleared away that the St. John's defense so compact right now into their side of the field. It's tough to get anything. Tough to get anything through. Martinez into Mediate.
Good. Now they need to get it wide. Good. That's a great ball.
Great ball out
great
to Nardi.
Ball.
Nardi to cross low.
Okay. Patience is what they need right now. Keep this attack going. They got the numbers in the box. Again, another opportunity.
Barr still with it now, out to Nardi. Giving it one more try. That one
That's
a little bit higher.
In, okay.
Cleared away. We're going to get a shot.
Oh.
And that one just goes off the side of the foot of Mediate. And it will be a goal kick for the Storm. So a lot of pressure coming from this Blue Hens. They now have 11 shots on the night compared to 6 from the Storm. They just couldn't seem to get through. It's nerve-wracking.
Yeah, I mean the tactic is right. It's just a matter of converting some of these services and through balls and
a little too strong off the foot of Barr. Still goes back to the Blue Hens. Delgado into the middle. He's gonna try a shot.
Oh!
And it gets a deflection. And Diaz saves it before it goes out of play.
Yeah, I thought that was going to catch the goalkeeper a little bit out of position, which it did, but he was able to recover well. That deflection really changed the direction of the kick.
Maybe that's what the Blue Hens need, just a lucky bounce somewhere.
Sure, it's all part of the game. Lucky bounces and on both sides, on both defensive side, on the offensive side, play a big role in helping keeping a team in games.
Bedoya out to Seppi. Seppi gets it around Martin. Seppi still with it now. Good job using his body by Mueller, but he goes down. Mueller's down, but the attack is still on. Barr up the left side. Barr still running with it. Back to Nardi. Nardi still with it now. Nardi making a run. Cut out there. Mueller still down on the back side there. Seems like
we've got a play down. Delaware playing with 10 men right now. Someone's going to have to find an opportunity to kick this ball out and get this.
We're trying to get back into play. He's limping back in.
Get Tobias back
showing,
in the game.
Showing some real gritty play there. Seems like he's just running that one off. Good to see him jogging back at full speed. He must have just banged knees. Must have been a little stinger or something, but he's back. To see. Looking for Rouse. Samson on defense. That ball goes out of play. It'll be a corner for the Storm, their fourth of the night here with just over 7 minutes left to play as we're going to see Borden. Bordone checking back in. Just over 7 minutes left to play here. Bedoya will take the corner.
Again, a good strategic substitution there from Coach Mazur, bringing in his starting forward. Somebody who's likes to hang off the back of defenders, just really looking to get in behind them. With Delaware committing so many players forward, they obviously expose themselves in the back, and having a player like him ready to pounce on that opportunity could really be beneficial for St. John's.
Albrecht trying to work it into the middle. You know, that might have been the time for the Blue Hens to mount an attack. Tim Parker was all the way up on the offensive end for that corner, but the Blue Hens couldn't quite mount anything that quickly. The ball goes back to the Storm, and the line judge, the side judge flag is up. Ball is out of play, and we're going to see Evan Reed, the senior, check into the game. Evan Reed checks in for Mueller. And see Ignacio Martens kind of stretching out a cramp there. Just over 6 minutes left to play here. Storm still up 1-0 over the University of Delaware fighting Blue Hens. Once again, thank you for spending part of your Thursday evening with us. The Hens All Access team alongside women's soccer assistant coach Nitan Soni. I'm Kyle Coulter.
It looks like they're going to have to make a change here. The trainers are coming on the field, it looks like.
We're going to see freshman Kaz Boshin check into the game for the first time tonight. He played. Boshin played a lot when Mueller was injured. He's a freshman, but he gained a lot of good experience this year. He played very well, and he's going to take out Martin, who played a super game.
Yeah, I've been very, very pleased with number four's play today. Really, in the second half, emerged as a key player in helping Delaware establish some attacking momentum.
Also, Mark Garrity is getting ready to check back in the game. I wonder when we see him. So now we got some fresh legs on the field for Delaware. Reed.
St. John's defending again, defending deep. This is kind of what they're going to have to get into, Delaware, if they're going to want to really capitalize on this next 5 minutes and 50 seconds.
Reed, good header. Up to DiRienzo. Still on his feet. Back to mediate.
Good, great. Good width of the field, stretching St. John's out, which is what we really needed.
Barr back to Nardi. Nardi's making a run. Cut out there by the Storm, and it's cleared. Borden with it now. Reed on defense.
Got to win this ball back.
Reed wins it back. He gives it right up to the Storm, but Reed gets it back.
Again, we need another
miscommunication there from the Hens. A ball in there to the middle. He's got Borden. Borden looking for Rouse. Borden still with it. Not quite able to pull the trigger.
Good. Okay, here we go.
And the ball goes back to the Hens. Just under 5 minutes left to play here. Barbero trying to start something quickly. Throws it wide out for Martinez. Plays it back to Boshin. to mediate. Giving up there. Rienzo gets it back.
Okay, good. Good feet right there to get regain possession of the ball after losing it. That's exactly what we're looking for here.
Jimenez loses it behind him, has to backtrack. Kamara is there, using his body to shield. Cut out there by mediate.
Good, back to Boshin.
Boshin to Martinez. Martinez still with it. Delgado
with,
has it
gets
now.
Gets him with. Good. That's great.
Jimenez out to Boshin. Looking to cross into the middle. That ball is.
And it's going to go out for a corner, a kick, I believe.
Booted up a lot of spin on it, and it goes out for a throw. A few more feet downfield. Yeah. Now we'll see Mark Garrity check back in. He will come in for Nick DiRienzo.
All right, so Delaware have been here before. It's kind of closing minutes of the second half, chasing back a goal. Let's see if they can rely on some of that experience to get them back in this game.
And that ball gets away from Martinez. It goes back to Sampson. 3 minutes and 30 seconds left to play here. Over to Barbero. Barbero now pushing forward, almost all the way at midfield. Looks up for Delgado. Taken away there by Kamara. Up to Borden. Into the middle, and for Kamara, looking out for Bordeaux. Bordeaux trying to play it in the middle, a little bit behind.
Okay, good forward movement here is what we need.
Just under 3 minutes left to play. Nardi looking to take it up the left side, puts it into the middle for mediate. Mediate plays it forward. He's got Jimenez. Back to Martinez. Martinez trying to sneak it through to Jimenez. Garrity with it now. Out to Boshin. Back to Jimenez. Jimenez gonna, Martinez gonna take a shot! And it's popped over the goal by Diaz, but the Bullhens will have a corner. A beautiful strike there for Martinez.
Good build up play, good patience on the ball, good movement off the ball, and then a great opportunity sailing easily under the crossbar. Needed to be intervened by the goalkeeper there to keep it out of the goal.
Here's the corner. Into the middle, popped away by Diaz. Nardi with it now. Nardi still with it. Play up to Boshin. Boshin looking to cross.
Okay,
and it'll be another corner for the Hens. Just under 2 minutes left to play here.
Believe it or not, this is plenty of time. Just enough time that Delaware need to for that one attack that they're looking for.
Nardi to cross. Falls into the middle. Goes up the head. Ah!
That's a goal!
Yes! Delgado finally puts it into the back of the net for the Hens.
That's
the
fantastic
freshman.
Fantastic.
With his
great
15th
play,
goal of the year.
Play.
The equalizer.
That's great.
With 1 minute and 35 seconds left to go
Delaware
here.
This is a Delaware team. You cannot write them off. You just cannot write them off. There's just a resilience to this team that they can really, really rely on. Each of them really knowing that regardless of how much time is left on the clock, that there is still enough time to score that goal. Fantastic work there, good resilience, good patience on the ball, capitalizing on a very, very good opportunity there. Good pressure, well-deserved goal.
Still a lot of time here, a minute and 35 seconds. Now we're tied up, Guillermo Delgado getting his team leading 15th goal of the season. Tying it up with a minute and 35 left to go.
And sometimes the tactic of hunkering in and really only trying to make the game as predictable as possible can really work against you sometimes. There's only so many attacks that you can absorb before one of them goes in. And thankfully here for Delaware, it's gone in.
I just wish we had gotten a better look at it.
A lot of bodies in the box, bouncing around. Looked like he got to the back post somehow and was able to be put in. So all that matters right now is it's 1-1 and we're still playing.
And Nardi will get credit, I believe, for that assist. And with that assist, the Blue Hens break their single season record for most assists in a season. Just under a minute left to play here in regulation.
Oh, that's a soft foul. All right.
Call there against the Blue Hens. 40 seconds left to go.
I'm surprised not everybody from the St. John's team is up in this box. I'm with 30 seconds to go with one big service like this. There we go. A few more people coming in
play
now.
Up to Bedoya. Bedoya trying to play into the middle. There's a shot and a save by Barbero. A huge save from the junior goalkeeper to get to that one. Might have just saved the game for the Hens there. We're tied up 1-1. 10 seconds left to go. And that'll probably do it here for regulation. And what a game. We're going into overtime here at Delaware Mini Stadium. Guillermo Delgado tying it up with a minute and 35 left. And we are going to, before we go to break, just tell us what are your thoughts on that second half there from the Hens?
There's only so many attacks that you can absorb before one of them really creeps in. And luckily for Delaware, it happens with, you know, a few minutes left on the clock, before the complete time expires. St. John's, that the tactic of really kind of settling back a little bit, trying to keep the game predictable, trying to sit back and absorb some of that pressure, and then really relying on those two forwards to really be one of their threats. And, you know, it's happened in the past. I remember Man United winning a Champions League game in just that fashion, putting on two forwards right at the end and scoring two quick goals to win the Champions League. So, it's a tactic that works, but thankfully for Delaware, we're on the positive end of that tactic, and going into extra time with a lot of momentum, a lot of confidence. I don't know exactly how Coach Henos is going to want to play this next two periods of 10 minutes, but regardless, I think we're in for some exciting soccer again.
And we are going to take a real quick break, but don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with overtime here on Hens All Access. We are headed into overtime here in this first NCAA tournament first round matchup between the St. John's Red Storm and your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. If you're just joining us now, I hope you're not. You missed quite an ending to this to the second half. Guillermo Delgado put it in with a minute and 35 left off the corner kick from Prince Nardi. Nardi and Mark Garrity both credited with an assist. And some overtime stats. Each team has gone into overtime six times this season. The St. John's Red Storm 1-3-2, and the Blue Hens 4-1-1. So heading into overtime, the stats would seem to indicate that the Blue Hens would have the edge. But really,
it's anyone's game.
You know, stats are thrown out the window at this point.
Yeah. I'll be interested to see what kind of adjustments St. John's want to make in these two extra time periods. They played a pretty reserved second half, and so you know I'm wondering whether they're going to be as aggressive as they were in the first 5-10 minutes of the first half to really open up the game again.
And Barbero for the quick attack here. Barr up the left side. Barr quickly back to Jimenez. That one cut out. Barbero with three saves for the Hens, and Rafael Diaz with eight saves for the Storm. Reed. Nardi has it now. Gets pushed from behind. That was caught a little too much body there. And Nardi, I'm sure he'll be just fine in a few seconds. But he did get pushed down pretty hard there. Call goes against the Storm. Sam's going to take that free kick. Ball gets back to Sampson now. Headed forward looking for Martinez. Martinez, Newell with it now. That ball a little behind Jimenez.
Yeah, just a misunderstanding there. Jimenez running into a space that he thinks Yule's going to play into. Yule then playing his feet.
Ball goes back to Barbero.
Oh.
And a little bit of a missed kick there from Barbero. Ball goes back to the Storm. Nardi has it now. Nardi up to Barr. Barr still with it now. Cross it in the middle. Newell has it. Still
Newell. Keep it coming.
Played up to Jimenez. Jimenez taking it back into the middle. Kind of loses it there as Martinez on a run. Martinez still with it now. Nice drag back there for Barr. Barr's going to take a shot! And it goes just over the cage.
All right.
Dieter Barr.
Again, good progressive movement there from Delaware. I got the feeling they really want this to end in this extra time period.
Diaz looking to boot it away here. Diaz, who apart from that flurry in front of the cage where Delgado scored his goal, has really been playing a stellar game for the Blue Hens.
Yeah, absolutely.
And, Blue Hens really fortunate to get it past him on that one, but they did, and we're here in overtime. Here in this first round NCAA tournament game. Winner heads down to Charlottesville to take on University of Virginia on the 24th. And the Blue Hens last made it to the NCAA tournament 2 years ago. They beat University of Virginia. It's a little bit of history there between those two teams.
Misunderstanding there. We can't afford that.
But once again, a misunderstanding there from the Red Storm. So the ball goes back. Ref kind of gets in the way there. Barr, good job there from Newell, who's checked back into this game. Jimenez with it, trying to get it around. Kamara cannot. Ball goes back to the Storm. Just under 7 minutes left to go. Out wide to LeVay. Reed. Back up to Nardi. Nardi with it now. Nardi's got plenty of space. He will take it. Delgado. He's got it in the middle. Delgado chips it. Nice ball out to Jimenez. Jimenez looking to get it back in the middle. There's a shot. Deflected off of Cole.
Got to get to that ball first. Trying to wait for that ball to fall onto his feet.
Reed will have it now.
Good play by Jimenez there.
Plays it out to Boshin. Boshin and Reed, who checked in for Martin and Mueller, who both went down pretty much simultaneously with either injuries or cramps. But they've stepped in and done a nice job here in the latter half of the second half, as well as this the first part here in overtime.
Can't afford to get sloppy. Here we go.
Nardi. Mediate. Looking to put it through for Martinez, but it's cut out there by LeVay. Newell with it.
Going to keep this pressure up from Delaware. We keep St. John's back in their half of the field, keep them on their toes on the defensive side of the ball.
Sampson. Boshin. Newell with it now. In the middle for DiRienzo. Out to Nardi. Nardi up the left side. Delgado taking it in the middle. Tries to feed it through to Martinez. Not really accurate enough like he wanted it. 5 minutes left to go here in overtime. The first period of overtime. Remember, it is golden goal. First team to score will win. Barr over to Newell.
Delaware got to continue to use the width on the field, something that served them very well in the second half.
And almost a dangerous play there. Gets out, but Diaz is there.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, continue to use the width on the field, stretch St. John's out, something that we've done very well in the second half. We can continue to do that.
Ball lofted up. He's got Mulligan. Mulligan, Nardi's coming up behind him.
Slow that play down. You just slow it down.
Mulligan still with it on his feet. Trips. Ball goes out of play. And it will be a goal kick there for the Hens. Barbero to take the kick. Barbero boots it away. Played out wide for Rouse. Now that's Jelani Williams with it. First time we've called his name tonight. Ball's crossed in the middle. Boshin's able to get a foot to it. Nardi clears it away. A long ball. He's got Jimenez. That's cut away.
Yeah, you can see
Camara.
What he was trying to do. He's trying to get his first touch to set him up central rather than keep him wide and try to beat the defender that way. Unfortunately, didn't quite work out for him then.
Nardi to Barr. Barr's got some room. Tries to thread the needle there to Delgado. Couldn't get it through.
It's a difficult ball to play. Such a tight space with the back line dropping as well as the ball moving forward. Very tricky.
Let's go, Prince. Let's go.
Nardi. Go back to Sampson. Yeah, with a nice move there out to Reed. Just over 2 minutes left to go here in the first overtime period. Sampson. Nardi. Chip forward. Trapped nicely there by Martinez. And Martinez goes down instantly, grabbing his knee. Back to Reed. And Reed will just play it out of bounds. His knee kind of bent awkwardly there as he was attacked from behind. Mark Garrity is getting ready to check in.
Going to close out this 1 minute and 50 seconds here. Hopefully we can go into the second period of overtime without having conceded. Sometimes a disruption in the game like this one can really stop the momentum for both teams, either, you know, whichever team's on the attack.
So might have just been a little stinger there on Jimenez, but he's ready to check back in. That ball's played backward. Out of play, it'll be a throw-in from the Hens, and you saw there he kind of kicked it, so the Blue Hens took throwing as far back as they could. Is that frowned upon usually?
Well, as long as they get the ball back. I don't necessarily know that they're, you know, obviously the team's not going to give him a prime attacking opportunity. But
it seemed like he put a little extra oomph on that pass back. That ball's played forward. Okay, he's got LeVay on a run.
Got to be careful here.
Ball's in the middle for Williams. Ball still in the middle. And there it is. The goal from Rouse ends it here at Delaware Mini Stadium.
Very unfortunate. Very unfortunate.
Jordan Rouse. The hero. The hero for the Red Storm tonight as they beat the Blue Hens in overtime. Unfortunately, you saw it coming there. It is too many men forward there for the Storm.
Yeah, and it was quick. It was quick. Those two forwards got on the ball very quickly and went to goal very quickly. Just Delaware, unfortunately, just not able to recover from that.
And the Blue Hens, some of them in shock, some of them livid at the refs. They felt there should have been a call. Barbero clearly upset. But the Hens, this loss shouldn't overshadow how impressive this Hens season was.
Yeah.
Coming back, their biggest turnaround in school history.
Absolutely.
With the most wins in school history.
Absolutely.
And they have so much freshman and underclassmen talent that I'm sure they'll be in this situation for a few years to come.
Yeah, this is, you know, if this is going to really set them up for, you know, many years of being able to play, you know, in front of crowds just like this one and put on a fantastic performance. There's nothing for the Delaware men's team to be really, you know, upset about. I mean, they've had a fantastic run this year. Of course, you want the run to continue as long as possible. But this was, you know, a good St. John's team. We had the better of the second half, and I was personally hoping that it would we would be able to finish out that 1 minute and 50 seconds that was remaining after Jimenez went down without doing anything silly. And unfortunately, fell to St. John's, and they were able to capitalize. It's the cruelty of the game, unfortunately.
Well, it has been an honor bringing you your Delaware men's soccer this year. Unfortunately, the season has come to a close for the Blue Hens. They will end at the record of 14-5-1, one of the best records in program's history. And that'll do it for us here on Hens All Access as the Blue Hens get a well-deserved round of applause from their home crowd here. For Neeton Sony, I'm Kyle Coulter. Have a great night, everybody.